Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to explore the Azure portal. In our previous video, you have seen how to create a subscription or login in Azure account. And in this video, we are going to launch the Azure portal and explore what are the different options available and how you can quickly create some services. That is what we are going to check it out in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin. So once you click on go to Azure portal, then it will navigate to sign in, and this is the first time when you are launching. You can check it out, some of the tools here. I mean, how you can navigate. Like, this is the left hand side panel is meant for creating the resource. So easily, as soon as you click on resources, create resource, you can create any resource. So in Azure, mostly it will be considered as resources. Most of the things, whatever you create, it's considered as a resource. So home is one of the thing where you quickly come here and top Azure services, common tasks, recently used, everything will be available in your home screen. That is what it is. And dashboard is used to customize the dashboard that displays exactly what you want. So it's like, you once you started working on Azure, it is not you are going to work only on SQL. You will create SQL, you will create some of the functions and resource groups, then you will create some other data factory, storage accounts, everything, lot and lots of things you are going to create. But some of the things you are interested in, you can pin it and use it in a dashboard, right? Dashboard, you can see customized dashboard that displays exactly what you want. So you, if you want to see resources, you are monitoring services, those things you can watch it in over here. So all services which will give you, you can explore what are all the different services available in Azure. Then these are the different things. Browse other, these are favorites, okay? You can tap it. Then this window here, over here, it will prompt you to search. So this tab, the blade kind of thing over here, left hand side appeared, right? Instead of this, instead of creating, some of the services won't be displayed. Instead, you can start typing it over here so that if you want to create SQL, if you want to create some functions, just start typing over here in the search button, that will appear. Then the another important aspect over here is like directory and subscriptions. So here you can see what are the different subscriptions your account is mapped to. So those things will be available over here. And now we are in a default subscription, like free subscription. So only one will be available to you. Notifications is important factor in Azure, where whatever you do, you create a request, you delete some services, everything will be notified here. What is the progress, whether it's in progress or completed or deleted. So those things will be notified over here. Then help and support is another important factor. You don't know some of the concepts while creating SQL Server or while creating some of the virtual machines. You don't know what that means, like maybe redundancy, I mean geographical location you want to keep, right? Which location? So you do not know about it. You want to know more about it, then you can go ahead and check over here. This is your account information. That's it. Now this is all about your Azure portal. You can go quickly and check it out here, and you can do some kind of customization using the settings box. First things is like overview appearance. Like, you can have theme over here, like this menu bar you want to fly out or dock, right? So you can set it out, this menu bar. Then theme can be dark theme or light theme. Once you click on dark, just check it out how it looks like. It will become black in color. And if you want a blue theme, just apply it and check it out. It will reflect it soon. So this is about your settings, like menu bar or theme, and some contrast colors, white background, none. So this is something about your settings. Okay, you click on it, then go to language and region. This is some languages people you can use, so French or Dutch, your own languages, very limited languages available right now. Soon Microsoft will add most of the languages, so you can change the language format here. So this is more or less your settings about it, and that's it. And how you can create a resource, we can quickly see. Now you see like create a resource, you are clicking it. You can browse through different resources you want to create. Let's go for a simple SQL database. I'm not going to create any, I'm just I will explain how it will look like. So I clicked on it. Now you can see what are the subscriptions, resource group. These things we are going to cover in a couple of videos, next videos. And these are the properties you are going to keep, right? This is what I said. When you don't know how the redundancy, where it has to be stored, then you go and check it in the help menu. So there are a lot of properties you need to key in and you need to choose. So this is what you will create the resource. Again, I'm repeating the cloud technology here. You are not going to install any SQL database, nothing. You're saying, I want to create this SQL database in this resource group. I'm going to give this name. Then the backend, the virtualization. If you don't know virtualization, watch my previous video, I've explained. So Microsoft will take care of creating those resources for you. Then you can start connecting it to it and start loading the data in case of SQL. So that is how it works. So this is about the portal and everything you are going to do in this portal, right? So that's it. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.